Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, above 18. I am the Black Shadow, and I welcome you to an LP which has been a few days in the making, as I have endeavoured to try to get hold of a copy of this disc, which has taken a little longer than I would have liked, but never mind. For it is well worth the wait, folks, for we finally get to tackle what... I would argue this is probably one of the biggest, if not possibly the biggest games ever to grace a PlayStation 2. And a PlayStation 2 had a pretty decent shelf life, mind you, and saw some cracking titles over the years, folks. This has got to be up there. I must admit, it's been a little while since I've actually ever properly touched this game, mind you, though. And I wonder if there's perhaps a couple of people perhaps on this on the channel. Obviously, with a GTA 5 obviously having come out not too far ago, sort of put a different slant on this title, of course. GTA 5 obviously being based in Los Santos, which, of course, is where a large part of this game is based, of course. And those of you who've played GTA 5, maybe only played GTA 5, never seen San Andreas, you get to see where much of the world you've been toying around with came from, to be fair, folks. It's a different world, certainly a different world, but it's very weird. You know, obviously, myself and played 5 a lot. Coming back now to this title, very interesting to see how things are different. But I do hope you guys enjoy. I have been looking forward to this, and we are going to be in for the long haul. What a game. And I think it's 10 years old now as well. Scary, scary stuff. I love the little bat, the sound, I love this. This one. I love that! I don't know what the hell that is, but I love it a bit. I really do. Oh, what a face to end it on. For those of you who are in the know, of course. Francis International Airport. Liberty City, 1992. So a good 15 years or so at least.
After 5 years on the East Coast, it was time to go home.
Before GTA 5.
Welcome to Los Santos Airport. What's up? Carl is sweet.
What's up, sweet? What you want?
It's Mama. She's dead, bro.
It's not a good start, is it, folks, really? Oh dear. Uh-oh. Filth.
Passenger, show us your hands.
Stop.
Get down on your knees.
I'm sure you guys recognize that voice.
Down on your stomach.
None other, folks. Samuel L. Jackson. How epic is that?
I'll take that, Hernandez.
Hey, that's my paper, man. That's money.
This is drug money.
My money, man.
Hey, don't worry about it. I'll fill it out later.
Welcome home, Carl. Glad to be back. You haven't forgotten about us, have you, boy?
Hell no, Officer Tenpenny. I was just wondering what took y'all so long.
Get in the car.
Ease up, man. Damn.
Dodgy policing this.
Watch your head.
Ah.
Oh, my bad.
Get out of here, you greaseball bastard. Stupid Mexican.
Can't say that.
Oh, hey, sorry.
My bag. Hey, man, my bag.
Oh, great. Our stuff's in the taxi. Well, we're never going to see that again. Well, great. We're off the plane in 5 minutes, been told our mother's dead, and we've now been seemingly arrested for something.
How you been, Carl? How's your wonderful family?
I'm here to bury my mom's. You know that.
Yeah, I guess I do.
What just happened there?
Thinking, Carl?
Nothing.
What the hell was
I'm
that?
I'm in Liberty City now. I'm clean. Legit.
Nah, you ain't never been clean, Carl.
Well, what do we got here?
This is a weapon, Officer Pulaski, that was used to gun down a police officer not 10 minutes ago.
What?
Officer Pendleberry. A fine man, I might add. You work fast, nigga.
You know I just got off the plane.
Well, that's a good thing we found you and retrieved the murder weapon.
That ain't my gun.
Don't bullshit me, Carl.
Yeah, don't bullshit him, Carl.
What the fuck you want from me this time?
When we want you, we'll find you. In the meantime, try not to gun down any more officers of the law.
Y'all can't leave me here. This baller's country.
I thought you said you was innocent, Carl. But you don't bang.
This is car 58.
See you around like a donut, what? Carl.
Officer Pendlebury's down. We'll be right over.
Hernandez.
Shit.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that.
Here we go again. Worst place in the world. Rolling Heights baller country. And I ain't represented Grove Street in 5 years. But the ballers won't give a shit.
Folks, welcome to the world of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. Now, before we get started here, a couple things I would like to just quickly point out. First of all, welcome to the world map. Doesn't allow you to zoom out very far, folks. This is obviously Los Santos, as I'm sure a lot of you will probably recognise a lot of this place. Not a huge amount of this place has changed, really, over the course between San Andreas and General 5. A bit of this area changed down here. This area down here as well changed around. Not too much, admittedly, changed around a bit. A lot of the changes mainly have occurred a bit further north here. Obviously, you'll notice we've got two other massive cities. One over there and one over here, folks. Not so big, actually, this one. Lots of little outcrops in between. The map itself is just gigantic. Compared to any GTA game that came before it, the maps in this are just enormous. They outscopes GTA 4. It feels like it outscopes GTA 4, certainly, and GTA 5 is still pretty big as well, to be fair, but just the scope, it's got three separate cities in it, is pretty impressive. But yeah, a lot of these outfield bits have changed. Like over here, you got like Mount Chiliad, which I think basically ended up somewhere around here. The army base that used to be down here is actually up here. Basic sort of thing, folks. But you know, other than that, a lot of the Los Santos itself is reasonably similar-ish. What we need to do is not press that button. We are currently here. Now, this is not a good place to be. In fact, in our current situation, pretty much most of Los Santos is not a good place to be. So, really careful of that, folks. Let me just...
Let's party! Then let's go traveling to the...
I need to sort out exactly what the radio is. I'm just going to turn the radio down a bit. We're not going to hear too much of it this video, folks, truth be told. But this is our state here, first thing in the morning. We got a bike here that's been happily provided to us. It's got $350, which ain't too bad. Obviously, Tenpenny and co. didn't take all our money. Thanks, follow the CG icon radar to get back to the hood. Yeah, something else I suppose I might want to... Oh yeah, it's green light. What am I doing? I might want to comment on, folks, is that I have certainly been looking forward to this LP, folks. This is an LP I've been looking forward to doing for a fair while. Admittedly though, folks, it should prove quite an interesting LP to do in a way. There may be a bit of language barrier, interesting interpretations, to be fair. There's not exactly the most, not exactly Queen English being spoke, but I suppose that's never really worried me much. But it was, San Andreas was a very interesting breakaway,
home. At least it was before I fucked everything up.
Yeah, thanks for that, CJ. Yeah, I mean, it was quite a breakaway, though, folks. From a lot of Japanese, a lot of it is sort of mafia wars and that sort of thing. Obviously, GTA 3, and that was Italian families moving on from there. You know, lots of triad, lots of bits and pieces like that. Whereas San Andreas, certainly for the start of it, very, very, very different feel to it. Completely different topic. And very interesting for that matter, folks.
Jesus!
Although, we've still got people diving
my
into roads.
Right now, pay up.
I thought we were through with this after GTA 3. Apparently not. I don't know who that is. They clearly can't drive. So, let's get home, folks, and see what's changed after 5 years. Yeah, pretty empty and desolate. That TV there is almost as modern
stop
as mine.
It. What are you doing, Carl? Brian, stop it!
Well, actually, saying that, folks, as a quick update for those of you who have been following along. In regards to me sort of getting my new HD TV, that is going through, and I get it on Sunday. 37-inch plasma. I get it on Sunday, so really happy with that. Superb. Anyways, enough divulging. CJ is busy having memories of being with his family.
You picked the wrong house,
fool! Well, holy mother of God, what the...
Big Smoke, it's me, Carl. Chill.
CJ. Oh, my dog, what's up? Hey, baby, you okay, man?
Nah, man. It's my mom's, homie.
Hey, I don't know why this had to happen, but I promise you, I'm gonna find out who killed your moms. The streets is cold, dog. Like it says in the book, we are blessed and cursed.
What fucking book?
Same things make us laugh,
that line.
Make us cry. But right now, we gotta take care of our business. Go see your brother at the cemetery. Come on, let's bounce.
Ah, yes. I need to put on subtitles, don't I? Oops.
You wanna drive?
Yeah, that's cool.
Nice car, Smoke. You know me. It's not cut. Keep the value in it. Keep
nice
it real.
Nice car? Freaking perennial! I thought we were through with these after GTA 3. Come on! I mean, really? Perennial? Nice car? Excuse me while I go be sick in a bucket. Nice car.
I miss you these 5 years, man. They're gonna be real happy to see you. Hey, what's up, y'all? Look who I found hanging around.
Carl, hey, good to see you.
Not particularly overjoyed, but never mind. Suppose you're kind of at a...
I can't believe she gone, man.
That's another funeral you ran away from, fool. Just like Brian's.
Ouch.
Hey, she was my mama too.
Not for the past 5 years she wasn't, nigga. And where the fuck you think you going?
What? Get out my face. I'm going to see Caesar.
The hell you are, girl. You ain't messing with them essays. You know we beefed it. They ain't nothing but a
look,
bunch of lowlife.
What the fuck are you?
At least I got Prince.
Oh, and I guess that makes you an upstanding American. Carl, tell him.
Carl, don't tell me shit,
as long
kid.
As he treat her right, disrespect you, and he did.
How the hell you gonna say that? Like it's any business of yours.
Fuck you, sweet.
Oh, shit.
Fucking asshole.
Here we go again.
This shit's real fucked up. Everything.
What you mean?
What, apart from your mother being dead? Things are going real bad. Here, let me show you running, man. Tony's buried over there. Little devil over there. And big devil over there. Man, it's just crazy. Everybody blasts on fools first, then ask questions second.
Well, at that sound... I better not... I might not touch on that. I was going to say it's kind of a bit of a perception of a... Americans and that. Oh, I'm not going there. Touchy subject.
Ballers! Drive by! Incoming!
Whoa, mother of God!
Oh, motherfucker, my car!
Yeah, some nice car that was, Smoke.
Grab a bike and pedal. Either you ain't forgotten that. Follow my lead.
I think it's got exactly the treatment it bloody deserves. Sweet car, my goodness. Let's get the hell out of here, folks.
Yeah, CJ. Yeah.
Swip pet, yeah, you can spell down on the Exmoor and get away.
CJ, watch your back right here, man.
Oh no! I'm stuck in the car! He's got a machine gun as well! Don't wanna be here! Oh, come on, this is a joke, right? Damn punks! Reprobates! I think we're okay. Only cycle with a limited amount of time. Hey, he crashed! Thank goodness for that. Well, got away with that one. Little bit of a mess there. But we're alright.
Shit! A bonus car's onto us! Split up! Keep up, motherfucker!
Yeah, there's you guys. I hope all you guys are happy with a little bit of foul language here and there. Those of you who have dispossession of that may want to cut the watching of this LP about.
Why you bother coming back? Straight back into the game, right, dog?
Now.
Wasn't this bad before you left?
I hope it wasn't.
East Coast got you all thinned out, home.
Which way we going? Which way we going? Come on. Going this way, okay then.
Yeah.
I think we're going back to the hood, also known as Grove Street to you and I. Cut through the park. You don't really want to fall down these little bits on the right there. A bit of a pain to get out of. Smoke, what are you doing? Wait, that's a motorway. This is a motorway, guys. What are you? It's a deserted motorway, but it's a motorway. I mean, we should have no business here. Come on now. Come on, CJ. Pedal like you mean it. Because there's a madman just taking pot shots at you. Son of a... Oh, thank goodness, I think
CJ?
We got away with him.
You embarrassing us, nigga.
Bloody hell, that was close.
I got with them motherfuckers, though. Sold them niggas who's gangster. Rider, nigga. So when you leaving, Carl?
I ain't sure. Thought I might stay. Things is fucked up.
Well, the last thing we need is your help.
Ah,
thanks.
Man, I won't let you down. I swear.
Hey, we gonna call some hood rats and chill the hell out. You want some?
I got a whole lot going on.
What is the rider doing there, wheelies?
Hey, yo, just drop in. We all hanging out.
Gia, and get yourself some colors, fool. And a haircut. It's embarrassing to be seen with you.
Yeah, I love you too, Ryder. Thanks. You can save your progress by entering CJ's house. You can save a vehicle by parking it in the garage. Or garage, depending on what side of the pond you're from. Walk into the marker to enter Carl's house. Mission passed. We're nearly dead. To quote CJ and a lot of his guys, this shit is seemingly for real. Oh no. Right, now before I go any further, I am turning the subtitles on. Because that sounds like a good idea. I'm going to play on the screen position because it's sort of to the left of my screen, but I'll do that when I finish the video because otherwise it's going to completely mess up my my thing. Someone's mentioned to me on Skype. I hope for goodness sakes that didn't come through on the soundtrack. Shouldn't have.
What up though? Why my oi? You ever had a serious drug problem? I can't imagine anything worse.
So we head into CJ's house, the Johnson household. Save a game, pick up the diskette icon. Saving a game will advance time by 6 hours. Not saving the game will also incidentally save the game, advance the time by 6 hours. What have we got in here then? We've got looks like some Jack Daniels over there. We've got breakfast, or what's left of it. That's probably about 5 years out of date. I don't think we're going to be eating any of that. Here's the save point. We shall save our game. We've got a lot of save files that I can use. Thank goodness for that. Really weird though, folks, because I deleted my old save file, actually, for me to be able to save on this. And I looked at it. Last time I played on it was 2008. 6 years ago. Oh. I've been on San Andreas sooner since then, but at any rate. Before we go outside, we can have a little look around the household as well. There's a few bits and pieces lying around. We've got, here's a some kind of bedroom with some reading materials over there. This is a camera, which I'm not going to pick up at the moment. I'm going to do it later. I'm not picking it up now because I'm not going to use it for ages. I've just got to suck through my inventory. I can't be arsed. But he can use that to take photos of stuff. There's a variety of things. It's kind of cool you can do that. There's some bits and pieces you can get for that as well. Cool missions require cameras, but you'll probably be giving them anyways. You can enter a wardrobe here. You can come here to change your clothes whenever thou desires, but of course, we've only got what we're wearing at the moment, so we can't do that at the moment. Other than that, though, we shall head back outside. Go see Ryder. He lives down the street. Just there. Oh. Who wants me?
Hello?
Hey, thought I'd explain some shit.
Oh, I smoke.
Sweet. Hey, what's up?
Oh,
since
sweet.
You've been away,
oh, wrong one,
shit
sorry.
Has changed around here. Grocery families ain't big no more. Seville Boulevard families and Temple Drive families are beefing and split with
love
the
that word, beefing.
Now we're so busy, Setrip and Ballers and Virgos have taken over. So watch yourself out there.
Yeah, I hear you. Thanks for the heads up.
Don't mention it.
Ooh, don't want to be in the market just yet, folks. Basically, what Sweet is trying to say there is that Grove Street here belongs to the gang that we were affiliated with 5 years ago, and sort of, you know, we were a member of the Grove Street families. Now, it used to be quite quite influential, quite powerful, but in the time that has expired, in the 5 years that we've been gone, they've basically shrunk. They basically sort of. They keep an eye on Grove Street, and they've got a couple other places here and there, like the market sort of thing. I think they've got one like down in around Pershing Square, and that's about it. A lot of the territory, gang-wise is concerned, is largely split up between the Ballers, which are the arch-enemies of the Grove Street, who basically have control of the vast majority of Los Santos. You've also got the Vargos as well, sort of like all the Hispanics, that sort of thing. They have a lot of these areas up here, East Los Santos, Los Flores, and the hillsides around here, basically. They control a lot of that. There's also a couple other minor gangs here and there. There's a small gang around here. There are a couple of other sort of families as well that used to be part of Grove Street, which have split, which are around this sort of area as well, folks, too. And a couple of other bits and pieces as well, here, there, and everywhere, folks. Of course, the police are around almost everywhere as well, mind you, of course. But basically, just to let you know, folks, that basically, if you see the Ballers, they will try and kill us on sight. The Vargos may well be tempted to, especially if you provoke them. Don't expect much protection from Grove Street because they have basically shrunk. And I think, actually, if you go into the stats, actually, gangs, yeah. Territory's held is, for the Grove Street, you see here, is 11. Biggest gang of the Bulls with 29. The Vargas with 13, and Grove Street, again, there with 11. So, the Bullers, quite large, quite powerful, very dangerous. So, with that little explanation in, let's go and have a chat with Ryder.
Man, what you want?
Seeing my homie. What's up with you?
Yeah, homie. Yeah, it's good to see you back.
No homie love? No hug?
Oh, for sure, my nigga. My bad. What's cracking with you?
Hey, man, what you strapped for?
Man, some pizza place keeps paying over our hit up, man. Shit is beautiful. Teach the owner a lesson. Fucking Grove Street. You damn?
I'm always damn.
Yeah. Let's go, bitch.
If I hadn't have played this game before,
show me how they drive on the East Coast, homie.
I may or may not be requiring a translator. Luckily, I have played this game before, so I know roughly what the hell they're going on about. Roughly.
Hey, ho, Reese still run the barbershop?
Like a raggedy-ass motherfucker. He popped his membrane years ago. The way I left that old fool in my head.
Yeah, I think I'll get cut up.
Whatever.
Go turn it down just a touch more. I know, obviously, I had a lot of problems with GTA 3 in regards to the radio. Unfortunately, because there's a lot of commercial music on it, it got a lot of videos, a lot of the beginning videos of GTA Vice City as well got blocked, unfortunately, in places like Germany, which I know people watch, so I'm going to turn it down.
I'll be cutting you like a DJ. So when you running off again?
I'm not.
Apologies, but I've got no choice in the matter.
Why?
My family, the homies is here.
We were always here, fool.
Yeah, but now I'm back, and I know what I've been missing.
Don't expect me to kiss your ass or nothing. You still a buster to me.
Yeah, okay, thanks, homie.
Yeah, don't mention it.
Yeah, thanks, Ryder. But yeah, I've got no choice, folks. I want to try and get as few of these videos blocked in Germany as I can manage, so I'm turning the radio down a little. Well, I say little, I mean a lot. Although, to be fair, at full blast, it's pretty bloody loud. Let's park on the sidewalk here. Might not be a bad idea, so the traffic can still get in here. I'm about to lock up on this. Welcome to Old Reese's, Hair Facial Studio, the old barbers.
Hey, shit, I'm not telling you.
I don't know what you just said in English next time, please. I don't know what barber would normally open at 3 in the morning, but never mind.
Here's the chair, CJ.
Not even high. No homie love from you.
You want it hip or fly?
Hip or fly? Yes, folks, you can get a variety of hairstyles as well in this game. Unfortunately, I kind of don't like any of these. You can go for a few different bits of booty. You can go for a throw, if you fancy, but, no. If yours as well, unfortunately, we don't have a huge amount of money, so we can't get many. The Yeri Cool. High fade. I kind of like the season the most, but unfortunately, I do actually have to get something. I kind of have no choice to go and get something. If you walk out with just the Caesar on, even if you buy something and go back to the Caesar, the game will make you come here and have something different, which is really freaking annoying. So I'm just going to go for the high fade, and I'll change it later on when I find something I like.
Man, I'm good.
So it'll have to do. He might as well
nice
be bald.
To have your back, son.
Oh, I'm glad you do, Reese. Do you know how to hold a 9mm? Probably like some freaking Terminator when it comes to it.
Shit. I told you he was crazy. Man, you jacked up. Man, what's this? Shit look ridiculous. No respect for the hood. All clean as shit.
It's a bad
looking
thing?
Looking too skinny, CJ. I want to get us something to eat. I'm going to finish this. Then I'm going to take care of business.
Oh, great. If you do not eat, you will lose weight. And eventually energy. Red bar shows how much energy you have. When you eat, you get energy, but too much. And you will become overweight, folks. You just hold the L1 button. And it will show you this little stats thing here. Which has a variety of bits and pieces here. Respect is... what you guys can imagine. It does affect how much influence you can have over the gang. You got stamina, which influences how long you can sprint, the muscle for like physical attacks, fat, and the last one we'll get to sooner or later, folks. But yes, folks, you do actually have to come into stores every now and again to eat, otherwise you will start going hungry and start losing weight, basically. So you can go to Pizza Stacks, there's, you know, there's Liberty, the chicken places, burger shots, etc., etc., etc.
I got crabs the size of baseball. I'm not going to be pushed around, son.
You've got what the size of baseballs? Oh.
Choose a blend of cheese and fat, sir.
Thank you. A few varieties. You can get three different versions of sort of standard meals. They do restore your health as well, which is nice. Or what you can do, up to the full rep, which will fully restore you. Or every place also does have a salad meal, which is more expensive, but will help keep your fat to a minimum. But we don't really need anything much. We do got to buy some, so I'm just going to buy a Buster.
Here you go. Enjoy.
Oh, goodness. This is a disaster of walking.
Give up the money. This a raid.
Ryder, not this again.
It ain't me, fool.
No one else is that small. I feel sorry for your dad.
Shit, you crazy. Let's get up out of here.
Same old CJ. Buster. Straight Buster.
Whoa.
Oh, shit. Run.
He's got a shotgun. We're out of here. Shotguns are damn dangerous in this game. I hate them to bits. They will murder you.
This pizza parlor's no pushover.
What you waiting for, fool?
Ow! He's taking a tire out! Ah! Shotguns are so dangerous in this game. Oh dear. Badness. Badness. Yeah, shotguns are, they're bad news. They are really bad news. Especially when you get policemen that start using those. Best of luck. May turn up the radio.
Better drop by
and
see Sweet. You've been yapping on about that graffiti too. Later, homie.
Cheers for that. Yeah. And we should. Are we not going to? No, I guess we're not going to. Okay, then we might need to do one more mission first. Right, well, what I'm going to do is... Put that up. There we go, that's about right. I'll get that put slightly as well. I'm also going to play around with the screen position, just because it is, like, really left of centre at the moment, so I'm going to play around with that in between videos, folks. But that is where I'm probably going to call an end to this very first video of Let's Play... Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, folks. Thank you guys very much for watching. And next time we will be getting ourselves introduced a little bit more to the old members of Groove Street, folks. And getting ourselves into inevitably a lot more trouble as we go along, folks. The only question really is, who are we going to get into a massive war with first? The Ballers or the Cops? I have my bets. Anyways, folks, I'm going to thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you next time. So take care of yourselves. I'll see you then.